This is part four of rational exponents, and we're just going to work through more problems. So first, just a reminder about some of the laws of exponents we've used, along with the new ones on rational expressions. All right, so we're going to use the properties of exponents to simplify each expression and only write with positive exponents. So here's one problem. 27u cubed to the 2/3. See if you could try this on your own first. All right, let's see. So what we have to do is raise each thing inside the parentheses to the 2/3 power. So we have 27 to the 2/3 times u cubed to the 2/3. Now what's 27 to the 2/3 mean? It means the cube root of 27 squared. So the cube root of 27 is 3, and then you could square it. Now, some of you can do that all in one step. I'm just doing the cube root of 27 in my head to write the 3. And over here, we're going to use our law of exponents, multiplying exponents. Well, when you multiply 3 times 2/3, the 3's cancel, so you get u squared. So then we get 9u squared for our answer. All right, so that's the first problem. All right, how about x to the 1/4 times x to the negative 1/2 over x to the 2/3? Well, all of these have the same base x, so what you can do is add the exponents in the numerator and subtract the one in the denominator. You can do this in two steps or one step. I'm just going to write, this is going to be 1/4, and I'm going to add a negative 1/2, so I'm going to write minus 1/2, and then plus 2/3. And I'm just going to simplify the fractions down here. So I've got 1/4 minus 1/2 plus 2/3. You can either just do the 1/4 minus 1/2 first, or you could just get a common denominator for all of them, which is what I would suggest. So for 4, 2, and 3, what's the common denominator? It's going to be 12s. So we want to write those all with a denominator of 12. So for 1/4, you're going to multiply by 3 over 3, so that's going to be 3/12. For 1/2, you're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 6 over 6, so that's 6/12. And for 2/3, you're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. So remember that that's not just a 1 on the top. When you do that 4 over 4, you're going to get an 8 in the numerator, right? Okay, so then be careful of your subtraction. You're doing 3 minus 6, that's a negative 3. Plus 8, so that's going to be 5/12. So this is going to be x to the 5/12. To be honest, most people have more trouble with adding and subtracting fractions than using the laws of exponents. So this is the correct answer. You've written it with a positive exponent. If you want, you can write it as the 12th root of x to the 5th as well. That's also correct. That's just writing it in radical form. All right, this is a complicated problem, and there are a lot of different ways to do this problem. There isn't just one way you might go about doing it. What I'm going to do is go ahead and just raise each thing in each parentheses to the exponent. So that's one way you can start. So I'm going to have a to the negative 2 to the 1/8, right? And b cubed to the 1/8. And in the denominator, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to get a to the negative 3 to the negative 1/4 and b to the negative 1/4. Okay? So let's simplify by each of the exponents by multiplying using the law of exponents where you multiply these two exponents. So I have to do negative 2 times 1/8. That's going to give you an a. Now, it's negative 2/8. You could leave it like that, or you could reduce it to negative 1/4. For right now, I'm just going to leave it as negative 2/8. And I'm going to have a b, 3 times 1/8. That'll be 3/8. Okay, let's see. The denominator, if I multiply, that gives me a to the negative 3 times negative 1/4 is a to the 3/4, and b to the negative 1/4. Okay, now as it turns out, I could sort of see my grouping of a's here together. It would be easier if I did change that to negative 1/4. But also, since it's a negative exponent, I'm going to put that in the denominator. So watch what happens. I'm going to circle the ones I'm going to put in the denominator. Anything that has a negative exponent, it switches from numerator to denominator, or vice versa. So if I write that in the denominator, it would be a plus 2/8. I'm just going to write that as a to the positive 1/4. And I also have a to the 3/4 that's already down there. Okay, so I've taken care of the two a's. Now let's deal with the b's. The b to the 3/8 stays up there. And this b to the negative 1/4, that goes in the numerator. But I'm going to think ahead. I'm going to have to add it to this 3/8 because I've got the same base. So I'm going to write that instead of positive 1/4, I'm going to write that as 2/8. I'm just going to write it with a common denominator. So now, let's just do the last part. We're going to add b to the 3/8 times b to the 2/8. We're going to add the exponent, so that's b to the 5/8. Whoops, wrote that twice. B to the 5/8. And in the denominator, what happens here? I got a to the 1/4 times a to the 3/4. When I add that, 1/4 plus 3/4 is 1. So that's a to the first power, which is just a. So that's perfectly fine to just write your answer like that. And if you want, you could write b to the 5/8 in radical form by writing the 8th root of b to the 5th. So, but this is perfectly acceptable the way I've done it. Okay. We're going to work on some different kind of problems. Assume all variables represent positive real numbers, and then we're going to use rational exponents to simplify each radical. So this means now I want to change from radical notation to rational to see if that helps. All right, so we've got a cubed to the, well, the 18th root. That just means to the 1/18. And then we can multiply exponents. So that will give you 3/18 or 1/6. Now we can go back and rewrite it. So that's the same thing as just the 6th root of a. Okay, let's look at a different one. How about the 4th root of 36? Okay, this is a little bit tricky. What you want to notice here is if something is a perfect square or a perfect cube, you want to write it in that form. And 36 is 6 squared. So watch this. Instead of writing 36, I'm going to write 6 squared. And that's to the 1/4 power because it's the 4th root. And now we're going to multiply the exponents. So I get 6 to the 2 times 1/4 is 1/2. And that means the square root of 6. So you can see there's an easier way of writing the 4th root of 36. It's just the same thing as the square root of 6. All right, let's do another one. We've got the 8th root of x plus 2 to the 4th power. All right, so we have x plus 2 to the 4th power. And then that whole thing is, since it was the 8th root, that is to the 1/8 power. So when we multiply the exponents, that's 1/2. And what's the easiest way of writing x plus 2 to the 1/2? Square root of x plus 2. Here's another one. The 12th root of a to the 9th, b to the 8th. Okay, so we start off with a to the 9th, b to the 8th, to the 1/12. And so we have a to the 9th to the 1/12 power times b to the 8th to the 1/12 power. So what's that give me? A to the, well, we've got 9/12, that reduces to 3/4. And b, 8/12, that reduces to 2/3. So we could write this as a to the 3/4 b to the 2/3, or you could put that back into radical, which would be the 4th root of a cubed times the cube root of b squared. Both of these are correct. One is in exponential form and one is in radical form.